Good afternoon, all of you. Now, today we are going to do quite a few experiments, but some of them are under the microscope, so obviously we cannot see that now. But I'll show you how to be done so that once you come to school, you will know how to do it. Okay? So, we will do slide preparations today. So, we'll do three slide preparations today. One is germination of the pollen grain, that is pollen grain germination. Second one is the nerium leaf. Now nerium leaf, that is xerophytic leaf, you know that it looks like this. So presently you can just take any leaf which is needle like this, and in your home just practice cutting sections. Okay, you cannot see under the microscope, but at least you can try and do the sections. And we will do hydrophytic stem. Hydrophytic stem, here I have hydrilla, which you are all aware of hydrilla. You might get water lily also, but this is an hydrilla, which is an aquatic plant. And we will do the stem dissection of this. Now the first, the pollen grain germination. So pollen grain germination, we require China rose. Now with the China rose pollen, you all know the China rose pollen, that yellow color pollen that you have. What you will do is, you will take a slide. Now you can do this in the petri dish also. You can do this in the petri dish also, but I do it in the slide. Why? Because from the petri dish, again taking the pollen grain into this becomes a little difficult. So I take this. This is the sugar solution, concentrated sugar solution, which is kept here. And in that solution, I mean from the solution, I just take few drops of it, solution on the slide, the sugar solution on the slide. So I take the sugar solution on the slide. In this slide, let me take this so that it's easier for you to see. I take a few pollen grain and I put it here. Yellow pollen grains. I put the pollen grains here. Okay. A few pollen grains, I put it here. I'll bring it inside this sugar solution and I'll leave it here for some time. Why? Because it's a nutritive medium, it will start germinating. Okay, so in the exam when it comes, you have to just do this and start doing other work. You leave this like this for the time being and start doing other work. Okay, so I leave this. Later I'll show you what to be done. Now I do the nerium leaf, that is a xerophytic leaf. And xerophytic leaf, you all know, it has sunken stomata. So you have to see that when you do the section, and also when you draw, you need not draw the whole TS of the leaf that is given in the book, a portion of it where the sunken stomatas are very, very clear along with the vascular bundle. So what I do is, I take a blade, as you know in the section we do, and I cut it in half initially. Now there are two methods of doing it. I'll show you both the method. Now one method, actually there are three methods of doing it. So one method is just holding in your hand as you do the sections all the time. Very slowly and very thin section you have to. Now the leaf will be in this plane, okay? So we say this is a VS. So we take a thin section like this and put it into the water as in the petri dish, as you always do during doing section. So this is one way. Again, I'm cutting one. You have to practice doing as thin a section as you can do. So you have to cut sections like this, as thin as you can. So as thin as you can do, you can do it. This is one method of doing it. Another is, if it is difficult to hold the leaf because it's a very thin structure, you can take a potato pith. Now, what is a potato pith? This is a pithing is a way of doing sections which are very thin or very fine to get a grip. So how to make a pith, I will show you first. So you will get a small piece of potato. You just cut out a small square. So I just take a small square of potato and I make a small slit. I don't cut it fully, I just make a slit. A slit. Okay, you can see I made a slit here. Now I will take a portion of the nerium leaf, just a small portion of it, so that it goes inside the pith. I take the pith like this, open it, put my nerium leaf inside in that plane, and I hold this tight here. Now you have got a grip here. Okay. So how do you cut it now? First you will remove the extra portion. Now when you cut a section of the, you cut a section along with the potato. So you get a very very thin section. Now when I cut like this, you see I have also got a section of the nerium leaf here. So with the potato, I've got a section of the nerium leaf here, which I'm keeping here again. These are much finer. I can do as many. I'm showing you once again. Make a pith of potato. When you cut the pith of potato here like this, you get the section of nerium also along with it. So this is one method, this is also one method, and the third method. So I've shown you how you can hold it in your hand. You can take it up, take a potato pith and do it also, just very simply in the way you chop. Okay, just the way you chop, see to that you do a very very thin portion, and I got my thin portion here. So these are the three methods, whichever suits you, you will do. So again, I'm doing it for one for you. You have to take a very, very, very thin portion. And chop. That's it. So you've got a very, very thin portion of a nerium leaf. So I have taken it. Now what to do with these sections? I'm sure you all know what to be done with this. You will put this into the saffronin solution. Okay, so I choose the thin sections and I put it in the saffronin solution. Okay, so I choose any three here, nice three sections, and I put it in the saffronin solution, and you know that you have to keep it in this solution for some time. Now I'm showing you the third one. The third one we will do with hydrilla. The same way hydrilla can be done in three ways. So I remove the leaf portion and I only take the stem. I only take the stem of the hydrilla. Okay, so only the stem. So again, the three way I can do hydrilla. I hold this tight. From top, I cut a thin section. I put it in the water. And I put it into the water. Now this also we can do with potato pith. Now how we can do it in the potato pith? Again a very small portion. I will use the potato pith. and I hold this. Now the extra portion I'm removing. And just see to that the stem is upright, okay? And I cut the potato pith along with that. I get the hydrilla. Here also you can see very very thin I have got. If I remove the leaf, the potato, I get the small hydrilla section. So here also again I'm doing it in this way. So when I do, I get a thin hydrilla section. So this is the second way. And the third way, as I told you, you can just do it by chopping. That is, you keep it on the table very very fine and narrow section. You do put it here. So by chopping I also do three sections. So I have quite a few sections here. If you see it nicely, these are all hydrilla. These are all small sections of hydrilla. Okay, so all sections of hydrilla. Now the same thing I do, the hydrilla I will take with the brush, the thin sections, and I put it in the saffron. Okay, so the sections I take it from here, the nice thin sections, and I put it into the saffron. Okay, so I leave this setup for some time to get the stain. Now coming back to this germination once again, what do I do after this? Of course we will give it a little more time, but since we don't have much time now, I'm doing it how to be shown. Otherwise you will keep it like this for at least half an hour. At least half an hour you will keep it. After that you will take a cover slip. Take a cover slip. First with a brush bring this here in center. Now you can remove some for later use, or if you want to do once again with another, you can keep, remove some. You don't need all of them. So you can remove some, otherwise it will be too crowded. So I have removed some in the corner so that we can do that once again. Now after that, I will just take a drop of saffron in. So that it takes stain. And little bit of glycerin. So that when you put the cover slip, you can see it nicely. Just one drop, that's it. Okay, now I put the cover slip. As you know, we should do the with the cover slip, we should always keep it tilted and then gradually with the needle bring it down. Okay, now very lightly, otherwise it will break. Very lightly with your finger you have to press it and move it to break the pollen grains and spread it to see the pollens. So like this, let us do. You can pick it up once more, bring it in center. Again with your finger gradually you will press it and spread it till you have, you can see that they are well pressed. Okay, Now with a piece of blotting paper, you can remove the extra portions. You can clean your slide nicely. And you get your slide is ready. Now what, after this of course you have to go and take it under the microscope and see. Now in the under the microscope, what you will see is, you will see just the pollen grains. That is the exine and the intine. You will see the pollen grains. Some very few, depends on how long you have kept your pollens in the sugar solution, you will see small tube-like thing coming out. Okay? So you will see the whole field, you will get a lot of this thing, lot of pollen grains with exine, outside exine, intine. Some of them you will see the pollen grain germinating like this. So if you keep it under the microscope, let me see what I see. See, if I put it under the microscope, let me see what I am doing. Yes, I can see quite a few pollen grains, and roughly I can see one or two has started germinating, just slightly a pollen tube. In fact, I can also see the anther, the kidney shaped anther, that is very firm anther. I can see this, and from here I can see that these things are all around. You can also see the pollen grains. Just check the pollen grains like this. A lot of pollen grains can be seen. You can see here only some with this, but mostly there, because I have not kept for a long time, hence mostly it is not there apart from one or two. But if you keep it for a long time, you get more and more like this, but definitely you'll get this. And I'm also being able to see the reniform anther. Okay? Let's see, we are trying. But I don't think it's possible. We are trying if you can see, but inside they won't be able to see.
আগের বারে যে ইয়ে ওয়াল মেমব্রেনটা অনিয়নের ওয়াল মেমব্রেনটা এসেছিল সম্ভব না.
উইল ট্রাই, লেটস সি ইফ উই ক্যান সি দেম.
সরি, তুমি বলে দাও.
লেট মি সি, আর শো আন্ডার দ্য ম্যাগনিফাইং, দে লেটস চেক ম্যাগনিফাই. লেট মি সি. I first take out my nerium sample. I take out the nerium sample and I keep it in that drop. I have got here two samples, so I'm taking one out. And I'm also hydrilla. So this is the hydrilla. This first, let me do the nerium. So this is the nerium. Okay. And we will put the cover slip.
Either one.
put the cover slip, the excess fluid we take out. You have seen that nicely it has taken the stain. This is a nerium leaf. Okay, so let's see what it looks like. Okay, it has come. Okay, I'll show you the diagram of the nerium leaf, which now germination of pollen grains, you all know that it will look like this, and you have to draw this diagram. You have draw only this diagram. Okay, you can also draw this. Now the nerium leaf, 1 minute. Anyhow, I'll show you.
देखो हम देख.
The main thing that you have to show, apart from of course the whole leaf that you will be drawing, this sunken stomata part where the stomatas are here and this hairline structure. So this part is something which you have to draw in the nerium. That part you have to draw in the nerium. Okay. Now coming to the hydrophyte, that is a hydrilla. Now for the hydrilla, your diagram should look like this. The diagram should look like this, where you can show the air spaces, where you can show the air spaces, which gives it the buoyancy. Because it's a hydrophyte, so because of the buoyancy, this part has to be there. So this part has to be there. Okay, so this air spaces has to be there. Now how you will do it? Again the same way, that is, you are taking a slide. Now of course this has not taken the color so nicely till now, but anyhow we will just make a slide and we will put it. Okay, let me see if I can get another one here. So that is how you are going to do this. Three slides. First one I showed you is the pollen germination, which of course it came very nicely, the pollen germination where the pollen grains are seen clearly, the pollen grains. Then of course we have the nerium leaf, and then we have the hydrophyte, that is the hydrilla here. Okay, now hydrilla, as I've shown you, it should have a lot of air spaces to give it a buoyancy. So So those are the three slide preparation that we had planned for today. Apart from that, I thought I'll just revise once more the dissection of the China rose, which you have already done, of course, and which you have done in, class 9 also. You have done in junior classes also, so you know that this is the epicalyx. You have to count the number of epicalyx, and when you write the floral formula, you have to be specific. Like here, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So don't give a range, 5 to 7. Just write, you have got 5, so you write 5. After that, you know what to be done, that is to cut the calyx, remove it nicely without harming the gynecium, which is a very tricky part. You all know that every time you do this comes out. Display it nicely, and then of course the corolla, you take, you can see that it's the epipetalous, it is joined with the andrachium at the base, so nicely, and it's a twisted aestivation. You can see they are twisted. I take them out gradually, slowly, without harming the gynecium. So this is how I do the twisted aestivation, and of course the calyx, you can see, is a velvet aestivation, and they are joined, so they are gamosepalous, but they are free, hence they are polypetalous. So this part is coming out. Now this is your monadelphus. Monadelphus, where the whole thing is joined into one, where you can see the reniform or the kidney shaped anthers, numerous. Now I have to just slit this part open carefully, but see that your base of the gynecium is hold tight. You remove this slowly, slowly, and see to that that you are doing it very slowly, okay? And you have to remove this part. Now after doing this, you will get the gynecium, that is the ovary. You can see the ovary is intact here over the thalamus, a cup shaped thalamus. And you have the five, you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stigma, which are sticky. Now I will keep it here to remove it, because it's very, very delicate, as you all know, and many a times it gets so. I remove this slowly, very, very slowly, without this is removed. So you have got your monadelphus. Now this is very sticky. Why, you know? Because it contains mucilage, mucilaginous, a polysaccharide, hence it is sticky. So you've got your anthers, and you have got your, if I keep this here, you can see this clearly. You have got the gynecium, that is your ovary, the style, and the five sticky stigma. And if you have to do the TS, you have to cut this ovary and do a TS from here. TS from here. The transverse section, you have to cut the TS from here. Now this is the opening up of all the flower parts and showing. Now one more thing that you need to do in your practicals, that is the LS of a flower. Now I take a flower from here. And when I do an LS, you know that you have to do it from the base. Hold this very tight from here. Do an LS of the whole thing. Now see, I have removed this part. So I have got the LS of the ovary here. If you can see this magnified version, this is the LS of the ovary. So LS of the ovary and LS of the flower also. Okay. So this part I'll cut little bit more so that I can see the LS nicely. this is the 1 minute. So this is your ellis of the flower. You can see this ovary ellis nicely. See the ovary, the ovary ellis part, you can see nicely. So that is how your ellis should look like. Okay students, so that's all. You have done 3 slide preparation, pollen grain germination, you have done the hydrophyte, and you have done the nerium leaf. This is your nerium leaf. If you get a leaf like this, please at least start practicing doing the section. Now hydrant, of course, you won't get, or say water lily. So if you get, of course, this is the hydrilla plant where we do the TS and the pollen grain germination with the help of the sugar solution. So those are the 3 slide preparation that is in your syllabus. Apart from that, the flower that we have revised, that is the China rose. So that's all for today. Thank you, students. We'll see you the next class and I'll tell you what to be written. Thank you so much.
Microscope and change with the death handle.